Hi friends, in the previous video we have seen how we can achieve data binding, that is flow of data from component class to the template using interpolation, property binding and class binding, and the other way, that is from template to the component class, that is called as event binding. In this video let's see how we can achieve two-way data binding. Two-way data binding means data must flow from component class to template and template to component class, that is bidirectional data flow. So let's quickly switch to Visual Studio Code. Here let's create a property, it is name equals empty. Now what we'll do is let's create a text box here using input type equals text. And now how we can achieve two-way data binding is by using a built-in directive provided by Angular, that is ng-model. Using ng-model directive we can see the flow of data from template to the component class and component class to the template. Okay, so to use this property, this directive ng-model, this should be specified inside square brace and parenthesis. This will be equal to name of the property, whatever we are declaring inside the app component class, that is name. Okay. And what I need to do, I need to use this property and bind to the template from component class to the template. That we can use by using interpolation, that is double curly brace. Inside that I need to specify the name of this property, that is name. Okay. Now let's save these changes and we'll run the command npm space start. This will launch the browser, but if you observe here we are getting loading, please wait, we are not getting the actual output which we are expecting here. So let's see what is the problem we are facing here. By using F12, let's inspect, that is console, what error is getting displayed. Now if you observe here, we are getting error, that is can't bind to ng model since it isn't a known property of input. What is happening with our code is the ng model directive which we are specified here is not recognized. So to make it recognized, we need to import it first from Angular. So we need to open app.module.ts and we need to import forms module, forms module from @angular/forms. Okay, so after doing this we need to add this inside the imports. After browser module we need to add forms module. Okay, now I will save the changes using Ctrl+S. Now if you observe the browser, the text box is getting displayed here. I am going to type something, that is Harsha. So if you observe here, inside the text box whatever I am typing, the same text is getting displayed outside also. This data is coming from the template because this is the view, and this data is coming from interpolation, that is from component class. From here, whatever the name we are getting from here, from the component class to the template, this is interpolation, that is outside the data with the text which is getting displayed. The inside the text getting displayed is from the ng model directive, that is equals name. So what is happening, why this syntax we are using? If you observe the syntax, there is square brace and parenthesis. So what does square brace indicate? If you remember in our previous video we have discussed that whenever we are specifying a property or directive inside the square brace, it indicates it is a, we are trying to do property binding. By using square brace we can use property binding, right? Similarly when we are using this parenthesis, in the previous video we have seen, whenever we want to achieve event binding. Event binding means binding the data from template to the app component, that is the component class, that is called as event binding. So we are specifying both syntax here in this case, like square brace and inside parenthesis. This indicates that we are trying to achieve two-way data binding here, from template to component class and from component class to the template. This way the data flows in both the directions, that is bidirectional data flow. This is how we can achieve two-way data binding using ng model directive, that is built-in directive provided by the Angular. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. Please like, comment and share this video, and kindly subscribe to my channel in order to watch more videos.